went into the PGCAP, I guess what I was expecting was someone was going to stand there at the front and teach me how to teach, to stand there and say, right, to be a successful lecturer, these are the points that you need to consider. You need to do A, B, C and D, you need to have this kind of layout, you need to consider these factors. And in the first couple of weeks, I was finding myself getting frustrated that I wasn't being told exactly what to do to become a good teacher. And then it kind of just dawned on me that that's not how I teach either. If a student comes to me and says, you know, how do I do this? I don't just say, right, you do A, B, C and D. I'll say to them, well, what do you think? How do you think this will work best? I get them to, you know, I question them, I get them to think about it themselves. And that's what I realised was actually happening on the PGCAP. We were being provided with various tools and various perspectives, but we weren't being told, this is how you do it. We were given the opportunity to explore what would work best in our field, what would work best maybe personally for us. But at the same time, we were also encouraged to kind of push our boundaries and do something that wasn't within our normal comfortable range. And so for me, that was the biggest kind of step, was realising that, you know, someone wasn't just going to say, this is how you do it. It was just, again, it was like a similar journey to what our students go through. It was learning how to be self-sufficient and work things out for yourself and be reflective and see what's going to fit into your own teaching style.